I couldn't have done it. I'm not a killer. I didn't kill anyone. I didn't. What are you all doing to me? No!
Unless you tell me what happened.
I nearly killed a woman in the laundry.
What?
Oh. The others call her Margo.
All right, take it easy. Look, just calm down.
Look, I think she's all right. Oh. I don't care. I'm in this place. It's right in there.
All right, take it easy. Now, just take
it easy. You've got to let me out.
Look, you just come with me and we'll see if she's okay.
No, please.
Just take it easy.
Look, you get the woman that said she'd help me. There's a woman. Please find
what
her.
Woman?
I don't know who she is. She was wearing street clothes.
The parole officer, Mrs. Morris.
Yes, I think
all
that's
right,
her.
Look, I'm not going to hurt you. I'm not going to hurt you. Calm down. Quiet.
Couldn't
calm
get
down.
Me out of here.
All right, you just come with me. We'll just take it easy. Now, come on. Just calm down.
Well, I'll be off, Julie. If anybody wants me, I'll be in my office.
Meg, quick. I need your help.
What is it?
It's Smith. She's been in a fight.
Who with?
A Gaffney, I think. I haven't had time to check on it. Look, Smith's too upset to be left alone, and she's asking for you.
Well, where is she?
She's in the rec room with Mrs. Knox.
Right, I'll go and see her. No, wait a minute. Perhaps a change of environment would be better for her. Why don't you bring her out into the garden?
All right, fine. Joan, check on Gaffney, will you?
Do you ever wake up in the morning and wish you hadn't?
For God's sake, won't you please do something to help me get out of here? Please.
I can't work miracles, Bea. You know that.
Well, I don't know. No one will believe me. I don't know.
But your record, the things you've done in the past.
Look, like what? Please, let me hear it from you.
This is very difficult, Bea. You must realise that. I mean, I know you as a different person. Normally, you wouldn't even ask me these questions.
But I'm not that person. I'm Bea Smith. Won't you understand that? Oh, why won't anyone believe me?
If you can't remember who you are...
But I can. I'm Bea Smith. I just told you that.
All right. If you can't remember who we think you are, how did you remember where Mum Brooks lived?
I don't know. I get flashes. But I can't make head nor tail of them.
What about that attack in the laundry just now?
I had to do that. They threatened Mum.
Yes, but why you? Why not one of the others?
Well, someone had to protect Mum. I didn't want to, but... Somehow I knew it had to be me. Then I found myself wanting to do it. I wanted to strangle her. I wanted to kill her.
And then you ran away. Go, Margo.
Oh, come on.
She doesn't look so tough now, does she?
God, no. I thought Bea was going to kill her.
I don't know. Did you see the way she ran out of here? That's not like Bea.
Oh, God, Jude. You're not going to fall for that, are you?
I'm not so sure.
She's pulling a Swifty. She's going to make mugs out of the lot of them, but not us, because we're her mates.
You sure, Lizzie? I mean, why didn't she let us in on her plans? It's truth, I don't know whether to believe her or not.
If that's the way she wants it, I reckon we should go along with her. God, she's done enough for us in the past.
Heavens, what does Bea have to do to convince you?
Nothing, love. It's all right. We believe her.
No, Lizzie, I mean it. Bea is sick and she does need help. And if you really are her friends, you'd do everything you could to make the authorities see that.
Okay, let's not get excited, huh? I'll tell you one thing, though, that worries me. How come Big Mouth didn't tell the screws about the fight when it happened? That would have blown it for Bea good and proper.
I'll tell you why, Fatso. One, I'd unlag. And two, if anyone's going to get Smith, it'll be me and not the screws. And believe me, I am going to get it. So you better keep your old peepers wide open. got it, cutie.
I'm sorry, Bea. There's nothing more I can do for you. Now, whether you remember it or not, you're a twice convicted prisoner. You've also escaped from legal custody.
But there must be a trial. I mean, there has to be.
There will be a hearing, but you haven't got much to go on.
Well, I don't believe that. I'll get onto the newspapers.
The newspapers won't be there. The case may not even get into court. Could be heard here.
Where?
Here, in prison, by the VJ.
Well, what's a VJ?
The visiting justice. Now, he could hear your case when he comes to the prison.
But they can't do that. I mean, there must be a law, habeas corpus or something. I demand a lawyer.
We're not here in prison.
Well, how can I defend myself if I don't have a lawyer?
Bea, you've already been convicted of your crimes. They're only concerned about your escape.
Well, they can't keep me here against my will. I demand a lawyer.
I'm sorry,
the
there's
best
no
there
way.
Is.
Look, if you were in an outside court, yes, you could have a lawyer. Even then, how could you pay for one?
I've got money.
Legal aid would be your best bet.
But I've got my own money in my bank account.
Where's your bank book?
Well, it's at home. That's where it is. Look, if you just let me take you there, I'll show you.
Bea, you sold your home. You sold it to pay for your last trial, remember?
Stop it! Stop asking me to remember!
But you must!
No! I won't! Not those things! No!
Let me! Don't!
No, me! You can't keep me alive! Get me out! Let me out!
Cut it out!
Let me out. No!
All we're
getting! Let me alone!
I don't understand you, Smith. That was a stupid stunt by anybody's standards, let alone yours. I thought you were supposed to have more sense than that. Lock her up, Officer Barfield, and don't take any notice of that sick act.
Now, just a minute, Jim. I mean, she could be genuine.
What, you mean that amnesia bit?
Yeah.
Oh, come on, you must be joking. If you knew half the moves that one had been up to, you wouldn't even consider the possibility.
I don't agree. I think Terry's right.
What's the matter with you, Meg? Has this new job made you soft or something?
Jim, we can't all be wrong.
Well, this time I'm not so sure.
It doesn't matter what any of us thinks. What does matter is what we do with B.
Solitary.
Oh, now,
Jim,
wait a
you
minute.
You can't do that. I mean, look at the state she's in.
Look, Jim, if she is genuine, you could be in a lot of trouble.
Mum has asked to look after B. Why not put the two of them in together?
Well, it's the thing to do if she is ill.
If?
Well, what do you got to lose?
And Mum's genuine.
Yeah.
All right, but she stays in the cell until lunchtime.
All right.
And then?
Then I'll consider letting her work in the laundry.
Thanks, Jim. When's Dr. Wiseman coming?
Well, Mrs. Davidson sent in a request for him, but I wouldn't hold your breath. Brooks, get your things together at lunchtime. You're moving in with B. Smith.
Thank you, Mr. Harrison. That will be a pleasure.
How is B, Mr.
Yeah,
Harrison?
Yeah, how is she?
I prefer to know exactly how the fight started in the first place.
There was no fight.
What fight, Mr. Harrison?
You seem pretty quick to defend yourself. Any reason?
Got to be ready, haven't you? Never know when someone might try to lay it on you.
How did you know about the fight, Mr. Harrison? Did B tell you? Well, there was a fight. Margot got upset about something I was supposed to have done, and B stepped in to defend me.
Trying to verbal me, Brooks? She's a liar.
Don't know anything about a fight. We never heard nothing, did we, Dawn?
No. Never laid a finger on her.
Well, someone is lying. Now, I don't think it's Smith.
If you think for a moment, you'd know how he found out about the fight. B must have told him. And you, of all people, should have supported her.
I told you all to shut up about it.
And you, you old bag, you're in big trouble.
I won't take a lagger in my laundry.
Lay off, Margot. Is it the best you can do, terrorize old women?
Ticker playing up again, is it, Bryant? Pacemaker battery need a bit of a recharge?
Grubs up. Come in, Mum.
I can wait. There's nowhere they can hide.
Lunchtime, Smith. Would you like to go to the dining room?
It's all right, B. We understand. If you want to keep us out of it, it's okay by us. We'll back you up. We'll convince those mongrels that you've lost your memory. I'll bet you're looking forward to visiting the shrink, eh? Better than sitting in here all day by yourself. Don't worry, love. We'll back you up.
Look,
All right, whatever you say. Please, whatever your name is, no more trouble. Please, just leave me alone.
I'm sorry if I've kept you waiting.
It's been a really bad day.
Come on in. Now, you're,
Nick Clark.
That's right. Yes. You've been placed on a bond by the court. Would you like to sit down? I'm Mrs. Morris. I've been assigned as your probation officer. Have you ever had a PO before?
No.
Well, there are a number of conditions you'll be bound by and some expectations that I require of you. Now, would you like to tell me a little about yourself?
You already know about me.
Well, how do you make that out?
It's in that file.
Yes, that's true, but...
What do you want me to tell you about it?
Well, these are just words. I'd rather hear it from you.
Not much to tell, really. Borrowed a car, went for a joyride.
Is that all?
Hmm?
Says here that the magistrate had to give you a severe reprimand. Why was that?
Must have been my past. Guess he didn't like shoplifting. He probably didn't have to do it as a kid.
Did you?
I did it, didn't I?
But did you have to? It says here that your parents are reasonably well off and that you went to a good school. But you rebelled. Didn't complete your HSC. Mainly through truancy.
It's all there, I told you.
And why did you leave home?
I wanted to live with friends.
Aren't your parents your friends?
You met them?
No.
When you do, you know what I mean.
Do you mind my contacting them this afternoon?
If you're a masochist.
And who are these friends you're living with?
Just friends. We live in a flat not far from here.
You manage all that on the dole?
Yeah, we survive. One way or another.
You realise, of course, that if you break this probation, you'll go straight to jail.
I've heard that tune before.
You haven't got your friends to hide behind now, have you? It's just you and me, Mum. Well, come on. Get it over and done with. There's no hurry. I've got all the time in the world. Yes, and you'll get more time if you persist with this sort of behaviour.
Think that's going to stop me?
No. But it's no use trying to frighten me.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, yes. You can hit me, but it'll only hurt for a while.
Don't bet on it.
Young woman, I was being threatened in this place while you were still at school, and by much tougher ladies. So you will not deter me from doing what I think is best for my friend. Oh, come on. It's all you people understand. Run out of words and you bash. Well, what are you waiting for?
No. Bashing would be too simple for you. But don't worry. I'll get you some other way. There's nowhere to go. So why hurry?
When do you want to see me again?
Here? In a week. In this office. But I will be seeing you again this afternoon.
Why?
Your flat, Nick. I have to see it.
What's it to you where I live?
Nick, I am your probation officer. I have to inspect your living arrangements. And if I find that either your flat or your friends are unsuitable, then I may have to recommend to the court that you move somewhere else. Oh, Nick!
Oh, hello, darling.
What was that?
God knows.
One of your disciples, eh?
Yes, a new one. I think I'm in for a bumpy ride.
Mm. Best friend.
Well, I won't know until I get out of this place. Ask me again tonight.
Now, you're not bringing your problems over work
Look,
again.
I will try not to, darling, but it hasn't been the best of days.
And you haven't forgotten that I've got two business colleagues for dinner?
No, no, I haven't. Mm. It's all on the desk calendar there. 8 p.m., Bob, plus two for dinner, business. Mm. Believe it or not, after today, I'm actually looking forward to tonight.
Well, go home. Take the rest of the afternoon off.
If only I could.
Well, I think you should from time to time. No, you seem busier now than you were when you were a screw. Prison officer?
Thank you, darling. That's better. Well, here we are, Mr. Nick Clark. That's you filed away for another week. You know, I can't help thinking how much he reminds me of Marty.
Now, that's one thing you're not going to do. Have you had lunch?
No, but it's a bit late for that now, isn't it?
Oh, I see. The confetti's blown away and the icing's melted.
Oh, shut up. Have we got time?
Well, if we haven't, we'll make it, hmm?
I still reckon Bee's a bit lousy.
Why? What's she done now?
She doesn't trust us, does she? At least she could have let us in on her plans.
Do you still think she's faking?
Oh, come on, Jude, I know she is.
How? It's because you don't know what she's been doing?
Not only that. I mean, look at what she did to Margo. You can't tell me that that wasn't the old Bee.
Look, Margo went too far. That Bee's temper just got the better of her, that's all.
Yeah, well, I can't see it. Good thing is that there were no screws around at the time, I reckon. Jude, oh, quick. I've got a foolproof plan to show the screws that Bee really is off a rocker.
I've never felt like that before. It just all welled up inside me like the violence wanted to take over. I don't know what made me attack her. Perhaps I didn't. Maybe I didn't attack her at all.
Bee, it did happen. You mustn't lose sight of that. I know you don't like to think you're capable of such a thing, but it wasn't a dream. It was very real. And you, Bee Smith, are capable of much more than you seem to think. Oh, Mr. Fletcher, excuse me.
I'm afraid it's time for my pills again.
I'll get them for you. Tell me, Mrs. Brooks, when the others denied that Smith attacked Gaffney, why did you lie and say that there was a fight?
I'm not a liar, Mr. Fletcher. I may be many things, but a liar is not one of them.
And the others?
All I'm saying is that the fight did take place.
And that all the others lied. I find that hard to believe.
Good. Then that means that you doubt that Bee retaliated when she was provoked by this Gaffney person. And it also means that the lady sitting quietly in there is not the Bee Smith you seem to think she is, but the Mrs. Smith of some 10 years ago. And with respect, Mr. Fletcher, I am shocked that the authorities have not given her the medical attention she needs.
Yes, well, the wheels have been put in motion, but personally, I just think it's a waste of time.
A waste of time? How would you feel if you were stripped of your uniform and bundled into prison for a crime you didn't commit?
Then who killed her husband?
Yes, but she doesn't remember it. And now she's been told she has no rights, nothing. Would you calmly give in, or would you fight back every inch of the way as Bee has?
I'll get your pills for you.
We're getting in the garden, Mum. You want to join us?
Oh, Lizzie, dear, I'm so worried about Bee. I think I better stay here.
Look, that's what we're on about. I mean, we're worried about her, too. Look, Lizzie's going to tell us something. She says it'll help Bee.
Lizzie?
No, dear. Too many years.
Well,
Come
on, you lad. Are you going to the garden or not? Yes, Mr. Fletcher. Of course, Mr. Fletcher.
Straight away, Mr. Fletcher. Bee, come. Some fresh air will do you good. Come on.
It's just like any other flat. Well, this is hardly the whole flat.
Look, other people live here too, you know. This is an invasion of privacy.
Ah, who's this then?
My probation officer.
Thought you looked a bit old for you.
Hi.
Oh, she's the cleaning woman. We have her in once a week. You know, she scrubs the floors, polishes the silver, takes the poodle for a walk, that sort of thing. She's just done a lovely job in the bathroom. Sorry I can't stop and chat.
The others like that?
It is his flat. And you didn't ask him if you could come in.
Nick, I had to see how you live. Now, is everyone here on the dole?
No. Gary works.
Gary? Oh, Gary.
Neither of the girls are home at the moment. Sue works and Samantha's like me. On the dole.
2 out of 4 incomes. That's hardly well off.
Who cares? We make do. And Gary knows someone who gets things that fall off the back of a truck.
Stolen goods.
Who said they're stolen? Do they have to be?
No, but the way you make it sound, they may as well be.
You'd think so anyway, so what's the use?
Nick, if you're handling stolen goods, it is only a matter of time before you end up in prison.
Look, I'm not involved in anything, don't you listen? You don't give a damn about me. Lock your office every night, lock me out of your head.
Look, my main concern is keeping you out of prison. Still, if you don't want to stay that way, then I'm sorry, there's very little I can do to help you.
Now you sound like the old woman.
Your mother.
Who else?
Yes, well, I hope to meet your parents today.
Good luck. If you're going over there, you'll need all the luck you can get.
Won't work, Lizzie.
I don't know. I like it.
I think we should get a second opinion. Why don't we ask Mum?
We haven't got time. Anyway, it was Mum who told the screws about the fight with Margo. I reckon she'll like that for sure.
Right. There's your pills.
Thank you, Mr. Fletcher.
Now, you should have enough there for both your evening and midnight doses, so you should be right till tomorrow morning.
Yes, thank you very much.
Hey, B, come over here a minute.
Come on. Smith doesn't look too well to me.
You're not still on about that, are you? It's all part of her act, Terry.
Hey, hello. Why did you do that? Hello.
Stand back.
Away.
Get back there.
She attacked me for no good reason. Get her out of here. She's bloody raving mad. I wish I knew what they was doing.
Don't worry, Lizzie, it'll be okay.
I don't understand how you can say that, Doreen.
Whatever possessed you all to think of a stupid idea like that?
Somebody had to do something. Heavens, B will probably end up in solitary for days now with no one to help her.
With friends like you lot, who needs enemies? Lizzie, you deserve a medal. I couldn't have produced a setup like that for B if I'd have spent a month thinking about it. But seeing as how I don't have a medal, I'll give you a reward instead. A free dollar bet on any race you fancy this afternoon.
Big deal.
For you, Lizzie? Anything.
I don't know what you're all looking so down in the mouth about. I've got to see Mrs. Davidson yet. I know I can convince her that B needs help.
Come in.
I've got B. Smith outside, Mrs. Davidson.
Oh, good. Bring her in.
Could I have a word with you first, please?
All right.
Thank you. For what it's worth, I don't think Smith's faking.
Well, I appreciate your concern, but you realise I must have a qualified opinion.
Yes, I know. I realise that. It's just that I've seen a lot of people with concussion, and so far Smith's behaviour has been consistent with theirs. I really do think she needs medical attention.
Well, as you probably know, we've already called Dr. Weissman. We can't do more than that. Would you bring Smith in now, please, Mr. Harrison?
Yes, fine. Smith.
Well, what's this about another fight?
Well, I know less about it than you do, Mrs. Davidson. I was completely set up.
Smith, Lizzie is your best friend. Why would she, of all people, set you up?
Well, who says she's my best friend? Don't I have any say in that? I don't know why she always picks on me. She's always hovering around.
Well, you consider Mum your friend. Why not Lizzie? You've known both women equally as long.
Well, there you go again. You're always saying that I do this or I do that. Everyone seems to know about it except me. Look, I'm just not the person you think I am. I shouldn't be here.
Yes, well, there's obviously no point in carrying this conversation on any further until I've spoken with Birdsworth. Would you take Smith back, please, Mr. Harrison?
Right, Smith.
Julie, Could you ask Miss Bennett to bring Lizzie Birdsworth here, please? Thank you.
Oh, Mrs. Clark?
Yes?
I'm Meg Morris. I'm Nick's probation officer, and I'd like to talk about him with you, if you don't mind.
Well, we were about to go out.
Who is it?
It's Nick's probation officer, dear.
He's not here. And you needn't bother calling again because...
Hello, Mr. Clark. I'm Meg Morris.
Yes, well, as my wife said, we're about to go out.
Well, I would like to discuss Nick with you and your wife, if you're willing. I've just been to see him at his flat.
A shambles, I suppose?
Oh, not so much the flat. I think it's the company he keeps. Have you ever considered asking Nick home to live?
Yes, I think that if...
That's your trouble, Mavis. You don't think. He's not coming here.
But, Jeff, if...
I've said no, and that's that. Look, Miss Morris, he's not welcome here. As far as I'm concerned, I've done everything I can.
But we've been all through
this. He's never wanted for anything. Toys as a kid, clothes, gadgets, you name it, he's had it. Bedroom of his own, radio, TV, everything that opens and shuts.
But we do miss him.
You may, I don't.
I do understand how let down you feel about his behaviour, and that's what I want to talk to you about.
Yes, yes, I know. Always bloody talk. You do-gooders are all the same. The kid had it made. Now he's made his own nest, let him lie in it.
Oh, Jeff, please. Look, I'll leave my card with you. If you ever want to discuss Nick's situation, please, don't hesitate to contact me.
Thank you for seeing me, Mrs. Davidson. Must have been a shock to you, too. I mean, she's my best mate.
Lizzie, how did you know I wanted to talk about B. Smith?
Well, I didn't really. I just thought you would, that's all.
What happened then?
Well, it's a terrible shock, you know, when your best mate knocks you around after all we've been through, too. B must be demented after that accident. You know, bonkers. Loosen the top story. Nutty.
All right, Lizzie, I understand.
Well, I think it's just a matter of time before she gets into door, or worse still, Mum.
Oh, don't be silly, Birdsworth. We'd put a stop to it before it got to that stage.
Oh, you can't watch her all the time. You know that, Miss Bennett. Mrs. Davidson, I reckon that Bee needs psyche head shrinker treatment.
You know, Lizzie, I don't believe a word you've said.
Oh, but Mrs. Davidson, you must.
Be quiet, Birdsworth.
I reckon Bee needs help. That's what she needs, help. And you can't deny her that. She's entitled to
it. All right, Lizzie, all right. Leave it with me. Bee will get her treatment.
Oh, Mrs. Davidson, you are a good sport. I always said that she's the best
governor
we ever had.
All right, Lizzie, that's enough. It so happens that Dr. Wiseman wasn't due here until next week.
Next week?
I have already spoken to Mr. Harrison, who seems to think that Smith's case is urgent. So I've rung the department and asked for Dr. Wiseman to come here as soon as possible.
Oh. Oh, hello, Mr. Harrison.
Lizzie.
Thank you very much for getting the shrink in to see B. That's the best thing you've ever done.
Shut up, Birdsworth. I've had enough of you for one day. Now get back to the laundry.
Good on you, Mr. Harrison.
No! I'm surprised at you. B. Smith's made a complete fool of you. Fancy an officer with your experience being taken in like that.
Now, wait a minute, Vera. I respect your opinion as an officer, but surely B's got the benefit of the doubt. Anyway, it's not my opinion that counts. It's a psychiatrist.
Yes, and I can just imagine what it'll be. They don't believe in prisons. You should know that. As far as he's concerned, all prisoners are little angels. The next thing, they'll all be faking something.
Oh, now, come off it. This is supposed to be a corrective institution, not a concentration camp. But the way you're carrying
on... Who do you think you're talking to? I've known B. Smith for a lot longer than you will ever know her.
All right.
And I know how these women react.
All right, Vera, all right. Let's just drop the whole thing.
Good night. Good night.
Oh, good night. Johnny. Well, that's that. Another day.
Hello, Vera.
Oh, come on, the world's not that bad. There is a life outside of Wentworth, you know.
Yes, you're going home and I've got work to do.
Oh, if you're going to be sulky about it, I can't stop you.
Julie, yeah, she'll have a drink with me. Julie!
Good heavens, has Julie left already? I didn't realise how late it was.
Yes, I'm just taking over.
Good. Don't put any calls through to my office for a while because Dr. Weissman is in there with Smith.
Waste of time, if you ask me.
What was he?
The whole thing's a complete fabrication. And what's more, Birdsworth's contribution proves it.
Well, if it is, Dr. Weissman will soon find out. So let's leave it in his hands, shall we?
Well, I'm just an ordinary housewife. Well, not really. I mean, I'm a hairdresser during the day, but... Well, that still means I have to go home and do the cooking and cleaning and get tea at night.
Does your daughter help you?
Well, I can't speak much of her. She's just a kid. And Jack doesn't do much around the house. But that's okay, I suppose. I mean, he works pretty hard during the day.
People have been telling you lately that Jack and Debbie are dead, haven't they?
Yes.
What was your reaction to that?
Well, what do you reckon? I mean, I know they were alive a couple of days ago. And yet everyone in this madhouse tells me they've been dead for years. Well, it's like being in the middle of a nightmare. Look, Doctor, if someone would just get in touch with my husband, he's got money. I know he'd get a good solicitor or whatever's necessary.
Yes, all right, all right. We'll come back to that in a minute. I want to hear more about this, what you call a nightmare. This fight with Margo Gaffney. How did that come about?
Well, I don't even know it really happened. I can remember having my hands around someone's throat and squeezing. I wanted to kill them. I mean, I really wanted to kill them. And then what was worse is I felt I had the power to do it. I mean, inside me, it just... Oh, it scared me.
Tell me about these flashbacks.
Nothing to tell, really. It's... It's like going to a place you've never been to before and everything's familiar.
No, but what were they like? I mean, what did you see?
Well, I remember seeing a woman being killed during an argument. And I remember Mum's place. Well, no, not her place or the address. That came later. But the number. I didn't remember her. I still don't. Even when I got there, I had to ask her if she knew me. And at times I feel closed in. And everything's black. Nothing. And I know there is something there. Something solid.
Anything else? What about Karen Travers, Frankie Doyle?
Oh, I've heard some of the other prisoners mention the last name, but it doesn't mean anything to me.
What would you do if you suddenly found out that Debbie was addicted to heroin?
Well, nothing. It just wouldn't happen. I mean, Debbie's not that sort of kid.
No, I mean, just for a moment, suppose that she did. What would you feel? Hatred?
Towards Debbie?
No, to the person who enticed her. What would you want to do? Would you want to lash out at him?
Well, I don't know. I wouldn't be very happy. I mean, no one would. Well, I suppose I'd ring the police. I mean, that's what they're there for, isn't it? Look, Doctor, I don't think you understand. I've got a good husband and a lovely daughter. Now, why would I want to spoil that?
I must say, Bob, the service around here has improved.
Are you saying it wasn't too good before?
Yes.
Well, I might marry the lady, make it permanent.
Not if you don't. Meg, I really have to agree with Ron. You certainly know how to make your guests feel comfortable.
Oh, well, we should be doing this more often. You're most welcome.
I get it.
Don't say that. You'll never get rid of us.
I'm Bob Morris.
So are you planning on any more? Or just...
Yes, she's here.
Yeah.
Yes, of course.
Oh, well,
Meg.
Excuse me.
The police.
Police?
Mm-hmm.
Hello, Meg Morris speaking. Yes, yes, I know him. But does it have to be me? All right, then. Yes, yes. Oh. Fine. Thank you.
What was that about?
Nick Clark, you know the boy you met in my office? Well, he's been picked up by the police and has asked to see me.
Well, can't I wait till morning?
Well, yes, darling, I suppose it could, but it means he'd have to spend the night in the lockup.
Well, probably doing the world a good.
Oh, come on, you know you don't mean that. Darling, I have to go. Oh, excuse me, but something rather urgent has just come up, and I really do have to go. I'm sorry.
Some other time.
Been a pleasure.
Oh, I'm sorry, darling. I'll be back as soon as I can.
Okay.
Wonder how Bee's going with Weissman.
Yeah, she's been gone a long time.
She'll be right. Wait and see.
You sound very confident, Lizzie. Of
course I am. Bee'll handle Weissman, even if I did have to nudge the screws to get him in.
Well, I still think it was a bad risk. It could just as easily have worked against her.
No, not a hope. Me and Mrs. Dave, I get on like a house on fire. All I needed was a chance to see her.
Mm. Oh, dear, much later than I thought. It's time to take my pills. Excuse me. Did you bring those biscuits?
No, I ain't got my biscuits.
Oh,
I
know. Ripped me off the last time. I'm so hungry I could eat my head feet.
Oh. You.
Well, you asked for me, didn't you?
I just thought my mother might come.
I doubt that. I went to see them this afternoon.
Told you. But you wouldn't listen.
What sort of a charge have you got him on?
Well, there isn't any charge yet. He was picked up with a bunch of young blokes we suspect vandalised a number of phone boxes.
Well, if there's no charge, he can leave.
Oh, we haven't decided that yet. You see, he wasn't very nice to our boys out there tonight. So we brought him and his mates in to cool down a bit. If he's prepared to apologise, well, we might even let him go.
And if he doesn't?
We've got all night.
Well, Nick, are you prepared to apologise?
I'm not sure.
Not sure what?
I'm not sure if I want to apologise. I didn't do anything wrong.
Are you calling one of my men a liar?
No.
Then he'll apologise. Constable, lock him up.
Apologise, Nick. Don't be a fool.
It's up to you, Clark. Apologise or back to the cells.
Great choice.
It's the best you'll get tonight. What's it to be?
All right.
All right, what?
All right, I'll apologise.
Then don't keep the lady waiting. Get on with it.
I'm sorry.
Sorry for what?
I'm sorry for what I did.
Okay. Go on, get out of here.
Thank you, Sergeant.
You're welcome, Mrs. Morris. I wish you luck with him. You're going to need it.
You're very lucky, you know that?
I don't know. I was just starting to enjoy myself.
Oh, well, perhaps I should have left you there.
Please, spare me the sermon.
Look, you don't stand a chance hanging around with a mob like that.
What do you expect me to do? I can't afford to live on my own. My parents don't want me, so what do I do? Live under a bridge?
There are other places. What about a hostel?
With all the drunks and arrows. Terrific.
Oh, they're not all like that.
They want your soul for a bowl of soup and a rotten bed. Then they expect you to pray to God and be grateful for it. No thanks.
You're not being very helpful.
Well, if you want to help so much, why don't you offer me something at your place?
Now, you know as well as I do that I've got my own life to lead.
Oh, yes. As long as you can wash your hands of us at the end of each day. You're like everybody else. You don't really care. Thanks for nothing.
Oh, Mum, we didn't know that you had to take pills.
It's not the end of the world, Doreen.
Well, you look pretty healthy to me. What are they for?
Diabetes. Nothing too dramatic.
God, you don't take fits or anything like that, do you?
Not on the hour, dear, but if I do, I know I can rely on you.
Huh?
Oh, I'm all right, Doreen, really.
Oh. How'd you go, Bee? Yeah, come and tell us all about it, Bee.
You just leave me alone.
Now, calm down, Bee. Sit down. They mean no harm.
Yeah, well, after this morning, you could have fooled me.
How do you feel?
Exhausted, but you wouldn't believe all the questions.
And what's the outcome to be?
I don't know. I didn't let on.
Well, you don't think Weissman's going to be any different from any other witch doctor we've had in here. Don't worry. You'll be the last one to know.
Well, as long as you put it over him, that's all that matters.
What's that supposed to mean?
It's all right, Bee. They're only trying to help.
Oh, really?
Well, you got me into trouble this morning, and I don't like that. So if you want to help me, leave me alone!
Darling, I know you're angry. I'm sorry.
They're very important clients, Megan. I can't afford to lose
them. Yes, I know that, darling. But I couldn't help it, really. You know I wouldn't walk out on you unless it was urgent.
Oh, convince me some more. I hope you didn't have to go that far to convince the police about young Clark.
No, I didn't. I let him off. Ah, it's a worry, though. He's convinced no one cares enough to help him.
Well, he's got to want to be able to help himself.
True. And I'm sure he understands that. I just wish I could get him out of that flat and into something decent.
I seem to remember you talking this way about somebody else.
Who?
Oh, come on, Meg. This young bloke reminds you of Marty, and you know it, and you want him to come and live here, right?
No. No, I don't. My predecessor at Wentworth tried that, and it was an absolute disaster. No, I learned a lesson there. I've got to win his confidence some other way. Hey. Do you want another drink or,
I suppose you realize Smith has presented us with quite a problem.
I can imagine. She's an interesting subject.
Have you been able to draw any conclusions yet?
Yes, I have. She's an amnesiac, all right.
And not a malingerer?
Oh, no, she's not malingering.
Well, that's a relief. She was beginning to worry me. Well, what happens now? What do we do with her?
Well, I'd suggest as little as possible. In her present state, she believes she's Mrs. B. Smith, an innocent woman.
Well, that's fine, except that we're contending with a small matter of a life sentence.
Yes, I'm not forgetting that for a moment. But it's interesting. The warrant describes one B. Smith and authorizes you to hold her for, what, another 10 years?
About that, yes.
Right. Except for one flaw. The B. Smith described on the warrant is not the same B. Smith I spoke to this afternoon.
Oh, I don't think the department would agree with you.
Maybe not. But there's such a thing in the Crimes Act as a plea of mercy. And once a case gets that far, it normally stands a very good chance of success. And B. Smith could very well find herself released on those grounds.
Oh, come now, Doctor. This is no ordinary prisoner. This is the highly publicized B. Smith, and the charge is murder.
True. But consider this. B. Smith, in her present state, is as rehabilitated as she's ever going to get.
Well, you could cure her, surely.
That's always possible, yes. But here's the dilemma. Should I? The woman I spoke to this afternoon is an innocent woman. Innocent of any crime. She hates violence. Now, should I try and bring her out of it? Should I bring back B. Smith's murderess? Or should I leave her as she is and argue for an early release?
Get up, both of you.
Come on, Mum. Time to get up. Don't feel like it. You all right?
I don't know. I don't feel all that good.
Well, perhaps you better stay there.
No. I'll be all right. You go on, have a shower. I'll wander down in a moment.
You sure?
Yes. Yes, go on, off you go.
Okay. I'll see you up there.
Yes, okay.